Hey there guys, it's Neil here. Now I'm just going to do a demo of how I do my PhoneGap apps, so and how to get started on getting your PhoneGap project started for iOS. So at the moment I'm still using PhoneGap 2.2, which you can find at the PhoneGap.com, and go to install, you scroll down and you can get the previous versions of PhoneGap 2.2. Okay, so that's what I've done. I've downloaded that and I've put it in my documents folder, and I've just renamed that PhoneGap folder PhoneGap 2.2, and to make a new PhoneGap project you navigate to your lib folder, the iOS folder, and then you right click on your bin folder, scroll down to services, and then scroll down to new terminal app folder. So I've got my new terminal there, and basically a bit of command line, which I'll put in the code on the blog as well. So basically what I'm going to do is create my app project. Now, syntax usually goes to a empty folder directory. So, what I mean by that is I've got my desktop, got my apps folder, and that's where I put all my apps. So, if I go to desktop, go to apps, and then I look here, these are where all I put my PhoneGap projects. So at the moment I'm going to showcase one of my clients, Mad Dance. So I'm going to put Mad Dance there, and then I'm going to put in my bundle identifiers and all that sort of thing from the iTunes Connect account, and that's what you get when you sign up for the Apple Developer Program as well. So and then you end it usually with the app name, which I'm just going to keep at Mad Dance, and then you give the project a name, which I'll give it Mad Dance. I press enter. It should, there we go. It's given me a new folder here, Mad Dance, and it's created a new PhoneGap project for me. So the www folder is where you put in all your web code, so all your HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and all your assets. Alright. Now, just ignore those alerts there. Now, let's have a look here. So that's all done. Now, I've also got Xcode 4.6.3. What I did actually was deleted Xcode 5 from my machine, and then I went to the Apple Developer login, I signed in, come on, refresh dude, continue, let's try that again. Just a bit slow here to go. Oh, okay. I'll put a link in, but you usually just log in. Hold on, you're gonna wait for me. Sorry, the browser gets a bit slow when you're doing a screencast, but I think it's gonna work now. Okay, so I've got my downloads for Apple Developers here. It should load very shortly, and as you can see, you've got all these tools and programs here for when you sign up for the Apple Developer program. And I've decided to go back, and because I'm using an old version of PhoneGap, and I want to revert to using the old version of Xcode. But I'll soon upgrade, but for now, because there's a new release coming out from one of my clients, Mad Dance House, I need to get this app out there and in the App Store, and get it reviewed and whatnot, so it can be approved. So I've downloaded that, installed it and whatnot, and I've got it back here. So I've got Xcode 4.6.3. Now, what else, what we'll do is, and that's how you get started with your project. So if you want to have a look, you just click on your Xcode project, and it should open up in Xcode. Just wait for it to load. So it's just kind of building it. And then okay. So the only things you'll really use are the folder if you get any alerts. You see your www folder there. I'm going to try and build it and put it in the simulator. So you just press the play button. And just waiting for the simulator to load. And here that Facebook message. Here we are, and we've got the PhoneGap symbol, and there you go, Apache Cordova device is ready. So that's all ready to go. So in the next video, I'll show you how to, configure your project so it works like a real app. So we'll see you soon.